that force of will to be, whether it is an earthworm or an ant, whether it is a creature in distress, whether it is you and I, the will to be, the will to existence. I get astonished by that vitality. And so when we can come into a dance with it, then that presence, that agility, that engagement creates a whole new quality of resilience. We can take it. We watched the other night, we watched for the first time the movie Dunkirk. Anybody seen that? Marvelous movie. Marvelous movie. What those folks were able to take. We are so resilient when we have a sense of purpose. When we don't have a sense of purpose, there's no resilience. When we don't have presence, our resilience is compromised. And when we have that resilience, and we have that presence, we have that agility and engagement, creativity is unlocked. And I believe this country is full of creative people that wants to be unlocked. But it's trapped in our assumptions, it's trapped in our prejudices. And when we have that, our state, our mood is resourceful. And our physiology becomes vitalized. And our behaviors become creative behaviors. And I believe that the holistic model is able to do that. So where does this take us? David Bohm was an amazing physicist, quantum physicist. He's the person that invented the term, the dialogical process, dialogue, deep listening. Deep listening. So David Bohm was saying, what we don't need in the world is debate. We watch parliamentary debates, and I don't know about you, but for me they become very, very tedious. It's an issue of ego and monopoly. That's the game. What we don't need is debate. You see, what we need is dialogue. What we need is deep listening. So I was very fortunate to be able to attend a two-day dialogue session where his widow, Sarah Bohm, was present. She was facilitating that process. And what dialogue says is you can identify a topic, but you sit with a question. And rather than responding to the other person, you sit with a question and sit silently. And then when something comes from a deep place within, you articulate that. You're not reacting to what this person said or reacting to what that person said. And what they said is going to be doing its work, but that's not the point. The point is that it's deep listening. It's deep engagement with what is being articulated by the people who are there. And then he said what happens, and he's demonstrated this. As people do the deep listening, and as they start articulating from the deep inner place, it seems as though another element, another unifying element, starts orchestrating. The dialogue process goes to a much deeper level. The understanding goes to a much deeper level. And people are able to access insights, options, creative options that couldn't have been there if it were just a clever debate. And I think the dialogue process is one in which thinking people that are prepared to invest time and energy within the theme of holism and Ubuntu is probably the next place where we can touch into a quality of spiritual information. Where we can touch into the information that is embedded in ourselves because we come from the entire evolutionary process and be able to articulate that into the world. And so I've just named this idea the Holos Project. Holos. the Greek word that inspired Jan Smuts to coin the word holism as we know it, but he actually called it holism, is the way he described it. I believe that the dialogue process is able to take us there, and that the crafting term that the Holos project. And so, just to bring this to an end, and then we can have a conversation around this. What I'm seeing is if we can get a group of people, groups of people that are prepared to explore the concept of Ubuntu deeply, to explore the concept of holism deeply, to explore the opportunities of dialogue deeply, if we can get that conversation going, then maybe what we can do is we can look at all the worthwhile initiatives around the world and all the amazing worthwhile initiatives in this very country. There are so many good initiatives, so many well-intentioned, and we can find those little missing gaps where the connection needs to take place, where we can create a web, a network that can inform and can encourage those initiatives that are moving towards integration, that are moving towards solution finding, that are moving towards gathering together those amazing futures that are scattered all around us. I think we can do that. With us tonight, we have a composer, Reggie Smith. She's the composer of this marvelous opera called Requiem for the Living. I was listening to a piece of this the other day, and one of the people that was involved in the performance of this, he said, we seem to be the condemned species. We're condemned. And it took me back to that musical Time. Do you remember that one? The Time musical, where humanity is judged. Laurence Olivier was the person that was the spokesperson for that. We've actually condemned ourselves. Requiem for the Living. We're alive. And so Rexley has very generously donated one of these for each of us here. Thank you very much, Rexley. And Rexley, and there's a pamphlet which we're going to be giving you about it. And Rexley has also offered that her initiative is not just an opera, because it's now become a movement, it's now become a charity, it's registered. And it could provide a platform in which we could do all sorts of things. So I'm just sharing that with you. So let's just wrap this up. We want to change the way we map the world. We want to change the way the prejudices about ourselves, about each other, about South Africa, about the world. We want to remap the world. And the main remapping is that if we can, through dialogue, we get a deep presence with this moment, with who we're with, we can engage with the real action of the universe, the real action of the moment. We can then dance a new dance. And as I say that, I'm recording the words from the book of Revelation. Father, they sang as it were a new song. They sang as it were a new song. We can sing a new song. But it's going to take the seeds of some folks that are committed to moving to a new place of consciousness. And if Smuts was right, that is already a potential waiting to be unfolded in this great cosmic evolutionary process of which we are now on the cutting edge, at least on this planet, then it's a potential that's inviting us to engage with it so we can receive what it has to offer us. Now that sounds idealistic. That sounds like a dream. But I think it's an alternative worth exploring.